In Greek mythology, Kerberos, also known as Cerberus, was the three-headed dog that guarded the gates of the underworld. So why would an authentication protocol be named for a dog?
I'm Dean Cifola, and this is the Azure Academy.
Azure Active Directory is a modern authentication protocol. It uses things like SAML and OAuth, but a traditional Active Directory uses NTLM and Kerberos. Now, the Kerberos authentication protocol is named for that three-headed dog because this protocol has three different components. Now, when I open up a command prompt here, I can type in the command klist, and I can see all of my Kerberos ticket. And if we look here at the very last ticket, you'll see that my client is the user Cyborg. The application in this case is a SIF share, which is a file server. And at the bottom, we see the KDC, and that's my domain controller. So Kerberos is kind of old news, right? So why are we talking about this? Well, remember I said Azure Active Directory uses these new identity services like OAuth and SAML. Well, to help all of us modernize and get past a lot of our old dependencies on Kerberos that tie us down to traditional infrastructure, Azure Active Directory now has a new Kerberos service. And because Azure Active Directory is a multi-tenant cloud identity service, this is being implemented differently than in your traditional domains. Now, as of this recording, the Kerberos realm in Azure Active Directory is in preview, so things are going to improve as we go. Now, to make this all work, you're going to need three different things, just like the Kerberos process itself. We'll need our virtual machines to be Azure AD joined, and then we'll need to configure a few things on them. We, of course, need the service that we're going to access. In this case, that's going to be Azure Files, and we're going to use it for our FS Logix profiles in Azure Virtual Desktop. And then we'll need to configure an Azure Active Directory application, which is going to function as our service principal, so Azure AD can talk to our file share and complete the Kerberos authentication process. Now, for your user accounts during the preview, they still need to be hybrid users, meaning that they need to be synced from your traditional Active Directory over to Azure Active Directory using Azure AD Connect. So we're not at that 100% cloud-only experience yet, where we can just depend on the cloud services, but we're getting close to the end of that journey, so stick with us and we'll get there before you know it. Okay, so the first thing that we need to get all this working is a storage account. That was easy. Now just make sure that this storage account is not currently using AD authentication, either to a traditional domain or Azure AD domain services. The two things are not compatible with Kerberos at this time. Now that we have a storage account, we need to create that Azure AD application so that Azure AD has something it knows how to talk to. Then we're gonna have to set up all the right API permissions to make that communication work. And thankfully that process has already been scripted out for you here in the Azure documentation. What I've done here is copied all of these different PowerShell blocks and put it into VS Code. And then I can just run the script. And once it's done successfully, you should see at the bottom there that success password is set up for whatever the name of your storage account is. And if you go over to your storage accounts and look at your file shares, you see that you've got a banner here at the top that shows Azure AD Kerberos is set up. So now for the API permission. Over in Azure Active Directory on the left, we want to go to App Registrations, find your storage account, open it, and then we want to set your API permission. Go ahead and click to add a new permission, and then we want to select from the Microsoft Graph a delegated permission, select Open ID, and then you want to select that and the one right under it. Click to add your permissions at the bottom, and now we need to add one further permission, which is also under the Microsoft Graph, and that is the user.read. So just type that into your search, select it, add it, and then we have one final step we have to do to authenticate. And this step needs to be completed by someone with the global administrator permissions, because allowing the Kerberos realm into your Azure Active Directory tenant impacts the tenant as a whole. So therefore it has to be done by a global admin. So just click to add admin consent for your three permissions and we're good to go. So speaking of permissions, we have to set the permissions on our file share so all of our users can access it. For the share level, go back to your storage account and then go to access control and then take a look at your role assignment. notice that we have granted already the virtual machine login rights for our admin and our standard ABD users. This is needed on any Azure AD join system so that people can log on to the machine. And we're going to want to mirror those same permissions for our file share. So click to add permissions at the top and add a role assignment. In the search box over there in the middle, type SMB, and then you want to select first here the elevated contributor role. This is that admin level role that can change NTFS permission. Click next, and then in the middle of the screen, you want to click to choose a member. And then from the picker here, choose your virtual desktop administrator. Select add at the bottom, and then review and add the assignment. Now let's repeat and add a regular users group. Add a role assignment, type SMB, and this time we want the share contributor. This will give them the rights to do whatever they want on the file share, but they can't change permissions. Click next and select your members and choose your standard FS Logix or virtual desktop users group. Add and then review and assign that role. So now you see at the bottom here, I've got four different roles. The share contributor and the VM user logins match, and then the admin login and the elevated contributor match. Now there are two ways to set our directory level permissions, the command line way and the Windows Explorer way. If you choose the command line way, you would do that with iCackles and it would look something like this. And there's a whole bunch of commands and switches that you can do to set the permissions exactly as you want. But since this is a video, we'll do the more visual way and use the Windows shell. Now to use the Windows way, at this point in the preview, we actually have to run another PowerShell command to give us that shell experience because it's not built in and native just yet, but it will be soon. Over in the Azure docs, you'll see this large block of code, which you'll copy and just put into PowerShell. And you're going to need some specific PowerShell modules on your system for this to work, like Active Directory, az.accounts, az.storage, and Azure AD. Now I've added above that PowerShell code that we pasted three different variables just to make my life easy, and that's for resource group name, storage account name, and domain name. That way you can edit those variables and just run this command on different shares or different domains over and over. Now once you executed all of that code, you can open your file explorer and go to your new file share, right click on the background and go to properties, the security tab, and then the advanced button at the bottom. Now we have three specific permissions that we should be setting at our directory level so our users can't impact each other. And this is found here in the FS Logix documentation. And I'll link to this in the video description. Back in our permissions, we need to change our creator owner role so it only has modify access and at subfolders and files only. Then you can add a new permission, and thanks to that PowerShell we just ran, the picker shows our domain as our location. So I'll type in the name of my users group, which for me is WBD users, click the check name, and it's all good. And these folks are going to need to modify at this folder only. And finally, the admin role, who should have full control over this folder, subfolders, and files. Click apply, and you're good to go. And the third part of our three-headed dog is to configure our session host virtual machine. And because this is a Windows 11 multi-session system, FS Logix has already been installed for me. So all I need to do is set up my FS Logix configuration in the registry. Speaking of policies, we do need a specific group policy to be enabled on our clients to allow communication through Kerberos in the cloud. Now, if you're using Windows 11, this policy is already on your systems. But if you're using Windows 10, then you must have the KB5007253 update. And that's linked in the documentation. When you have all that, you should see this policy on your client. Just enable that. And then there's one last thing, and that is a registry key. You see, when you use Azure Active Directory with a roaming profile solution like FS Logix, the credential keys are stored in your credential manager, and they must belong to the profile that's currently loading. This is what lets your profile log on to many different VMs instead of being limited to just one. Now, once you've completed all of that, go ahead and log out of any active sessions in Virtual Desktop, and this will make sure that you have your latest Azure AD primary refresh token. And when you log back in, you'll see FS Logix is starting up. And after that login is complete, go ahead and open a command prompt and type in the command klist. And at the bottom, you can see a SIF share, and this is for our FSLogix user profiles. And the user here is Cyborg, the server or application is a storage account, and the KDC is the new Azure AD Kerberos Realm, kerberos.microsoftonline.com. And if we check out the status of our machine with the command /dsregcmd /status, we can see our system is Azure AD joined only. This is not joined to a traditional domain at all. Everything is coming through Azure Active Directory. And back in Azure AD, if you scroll down on the left there for your sign-in logs, you can see for me that the third one down is Cyborg logging onto a storage account. So click that, and you can see the three different components of Kerberos. Our client is Cyborg, the application is my storage account, and the KDC token issuer is Azure AD. And all of that is done using the Kerberos agent you see there at the bottom. So we are really close to the 100% cloud experience, so be sure that you're subscribed and you've clicked the notification bell so you don't miss anything in this series as we go all cloud, which you can see right over there. So thanks for joining me for this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Happy learning.